19. Now, I'll do another video on the containers. I love containers. For real, if containers were a person, we might just be in a relationship.
Let's take a look at what I have in my containers. Now, as I stated in a previous video, this used to be our loft area, but we converted it into a classroom. Now, storage is very, very important for me because I like to stay organized and I need to know what I have. This particular container is one of those little cubby cloth situations that you can pick up almost anywhere. And here we have art supplies, or some of the art supplies, and it just helps me to put them in these little containers that have the individual compartments. And I label them so I know exactly what's in here. I find that Ziploc bags are my best friend, and this is why. These pony beads would be all over the place if I just relied on the container that they came in. We also have popsicle sticks and tongue compressors. Again, I put them in Ziploc bags. Clothespins are mini clothespins. I use these for sometimes counting. We also use these to put the artwork on the wall. Feathers for art. We have some air dry clay. These little, what do you call these? These little tags that you put on gifts, but we use these for art as well. They can use them to embellish hair or just whatever they feel inclined to do with them. And this is one of those hanging decoration doomahickeys that I have not opened yet, and I'm not even sure why this is in here or what I was going to use it for. Lastly, here on the side, we have pipe cleaners, tissue, paper, and lastly, I have some construction paper. Sometimes I don't feel like running downstairs to my office to get the construction paper, so it's always nice to have construction paper up here. And I also put scraps of construction paper in here. All right, moving along to our next bin. This is where I store all of my day-to-day operation sort of supplies. So we have our dry erase markers, pencils. These are my favorite pencils, and they make a really nice kindergarten pencil that's really chubby and fat. We have some jumbo sidewalk chalk. Now, what I would suggest, if you have a homeschool classroom and you have one of those chalkboards, don't get the skinny chalk. Get the sidewalk chalk because it's easier to handle and it comes in all these cool colors. And they don't break as easily as the skinny chalk. Post-it notes, a bag of old crayons. I go through so many of these glue sticks. I buy them by the 30 to 100, and I prefer the glue stick that has the disappearing action so that they're not overzealous with when they use the glue. When I get the clear ones, they just will just keep piling it up, piling it up, piling it up, whereas with the purple ones, they can actually see how much glue they're putting down. Various erasers, extra crayons, and some takeout containers. I'm not sure why this is in here, but it's in here. This particular container just houses the wires for the modem and the cable box and the controller for the PS4. Y'all see that? Do y'all see that? Girl. And it also has 3D glasses and some of the PS4 games. I prefer to store my wires and things in here so that I don't have a whole lot of visual clutter. I hate clutter and I hate the visual variety. Now moving over here, we have some instruments. I'm not going to take all this stuff out, but there's a xylophone, like a couple of xylophones, a tambourine, some maracas, and it's just various Melissa and Doug instruments. And this container, this is probably one of my favorite containers because everything in here is just amazing. Solid geometric shapes, and these are made of wood. We have some that's made of foam, these right here, but I prefer the ones that's made of wood. Pretend money, a jumbo dice for math, blank jumbo dice that you can write whatever letter or number or dot on here, and there are two of these. Here's the other one, and I picked these up from the dollar store. The dollar store really do have like some amazing things. Mini clocks. Now, I didn't need all these clocks initially, but I found that I did end up using them because I can set the different times and we can play like matching games and things like that. And this is what the clock looks like outside of the box. So you have the different color hand for the minute and the hour hand, and it has this thing right here that you stick in there that allows it to sit up. Jumbo playing cards. A bag of rubber bands that goes with this thing right here. I can't think of what this thing is called. I'll put it on the screen, but you use the rubber bands with this. Bloop! That thing is actually called a two-sided geo board. And when I tell you that I'm really about these plastic bags, listen, this is my life. I store all of the manuals for all of this stuff in here. Now, unlike the traditional dice where it has the dots, this one actually has the numbers up there. So you can use these in a variety of ways for adding and subtracting. It's really good stuff. There is a paper dice that was made for whatever reason. And we have these. I forgot what these things are called. They're like these beads that you add water to them and they swell up. They love these here. And I like them too. They're really fun to play with. And we are going to move over here. Let's start at the bottom. I have the labels so I know exactly what's in here. I don't like containers that don't have labels because I don't have time to be trying to figure out what's going on. So we have paint supplies, kinetic sand, pegs, first aid, literacy, first aid reading. So let's start with this one right here. Okay, so I'm not going to go through every one of the containers that's like this because there are a lot of them, but they are basically all the same, if that makes any sense. What I do is I store all of my materials for reading inside of the containers. And I store them in the order in which I will need to use them. So for one of our next units, we'll be talking about cheetahs. Right here, we have our fluency passages. We have the readers here that go with the lesson. These are the picture cards that we'll use to sort and to group based on a particular letter blend, or we'll use it for spelling. The same for literacy. So for my particular unit, I have all of the vocabulary word cards printed out, and behind it are the sheets that go with the lesson. So all of my printed materials in these type of containers, it follows the same format. Next, we have pegs. This is a pegboard that comes with these pegs here. I mentioned before that I use a Tara West curriculum, and she also makes these here. So with this, they are able to look at the picture and then create it with the pegs. Kinetic sand. This is such a really fun tactile experience. Our paint supplies live in here. So we have a smock, finger paints. This is like a letter ink pad situation. Dot markers. These paint containers here that I like to pour in these containers. And let me show you why I like these containers. One, it has this situation, so you're less likely to have spills and things. And then once you're finished, if you don't feel like pouring the paint out, you can always cover it up with the top. Paint brushes in here that are color coordinated that go with these. And a watercolor paint set. Over here, the grammar materials. I'm not going to show you all of that stuff because we're working on a budget. Here we have our blocks and tangrams. So let me show you what all this stuff is about. So we have our different blocks here. As I said in a previous video, our two-year-old loves to build. So when I'm having lessons and she doesn't want to be bothered, I will put these blocks out and she will play with them. And I believe these are Melissa and Doug. Then you have the tangrams. Here there are some blocks that have a string here so you can always feed through, working on those fine motor skills. And with the tangrams, which are these things here, you have these boards that you can use to build the design. You have it on this side. And then you have a picture on this side. This will keep them busy. Well, the two-year-old anyway, because she loves to just play with things like this. And also from Tara West, we have the Stack It cards, which allows them to stack and create a design based on the picture. Here we have the firsty math cards, and this can be anything from addition and subtraction cards, graphing sort of material. Everything in here can be reused. You see this right here? That actually belongs in here. And here we have all of the worksheets for math. Firsty intervention, all of the materials live in here. And in this box is some of the STEM supplies that we have. I have a scale, a large magnet. This clamp right here actually goes to a heat lamp that we use in one of the STEM or science activities. A magnifying glass, a flashlight, slotted spoon. These little containers right here I got from the dollar store. And in one of our activities, we do smells. Like, can you determine what smell this is? So what I'll do is I will take a cotton ball, put an essence of fragrance or something on the cotton ball, put it in here, and then they'll be able to smell it to determine whether or not they like that smell, or does it smell spicy, does it smell sweet, things like that. This is a pine cone that she'll be using with regard to touch. A sponge, I'm not sure why that's in there, but I'm sure it has something to do with tactile something or another. This is the other part of the clamp that goes with the heat lamp. And these right here, you know how you take two soda bottles and you put them together and you put a little bit of water in there and then you do the little swirling thing and it makes a hurricane tornado situation? Okay, this is the connector here. When you buy this stuff online, you can't just buy one. So you end up having to buy a whole pack. And what I've been meaning to do is to give it to some of my family and friends that have small children so that they can use it as well. Also in the shelf that I don't think I mentioned before is we have an abacus, which is helpful for adding and subtracting. Over here, we have other materials that I use for teaching. So we have phonics, science, health, social studies, and in here, we have our Play-Doh. Now, with the Play-Doh, we have these little containers and some of these emotion cards that I purchased from Tara West. And what they do is they will just cover up this area right here with the Play-Doh. Some more Play-Doh shapes. And the cool thing about this is that sometimes I don't feel like having a regular teaching day, so we will just get up in here and use Play-Doh so that I don't feel like I'm wasting a day. We have some more STEM. Now, this is the STEM that actually goes with the lesson here, not the STEM supplies. Another thing we have is some more centers. With the cubes, they can make different designs here. With chips, they can just take this color chip that matches, and I'll show you the chips that we use. And there's also one with the tanagrams. There's one with the cubes that they can use here as well. There is another hands-on thing here that uses the pony beads, and they'll just take a matching color pony bead and stick it on here. What I like to do, instead of giving them this whole bag of pony beads, I will just take a few of them and put it in here, so that it'll be easier to clean up some of the pony beads that spill from this size versus here. All right, some other things on the shelf that I may not have talked about before. We have a clipboard. Believe it or not, we do a lot of school in the car. So, and you're like, Shug, what are you talking about? So my husband will drive and then I will teach. And there are certain things that she can do on the clipboard. It just, sometimes you just gotta break it up and just do something different or go outside with it. So use the clipboard. We have these pouches. I know I've mentioned them before, but I swear by these because we can work on spelling words, writing. So if there's an issue where I'm like, I don't like how that particular letter looks, let's practice that. I'll pull this bad boy out and then she can practice. And you're probably like, Shug, is that dust? It is dust, but it came from the chalkboard because the little one likes to draw on the chalkboard. Alrighty, I'm not gonna go into all these books. So here, I don't think I've mentioned before, is this is a pen that I got from the dollar store, and these are these magnetic letters. So we work on spelling with that. If you miss my homeschooling holiday decoration video, I'm going to link it down below. And here, I store all of the work that we're going to use for the week in order of the first thing that we're going to use up into the last thing that we're going to use. Now, we are finished with school for the year, well, for 2020. And I just went ahead and put this together so that when 2021 rolls around, we're all set. Chapstick, because child, when I tell you, your lips get dry when you're talking. Now, in these containers, there are various things. These are actually food containers. I'm trying to think of the name of them, but I got them from this store called At Home, but I believe you can find these online. Like, I've seen these containers online. And these containers right here, these are really useful boxes. I think that's what they're called. I got these from Office Max. Do not buy these from Amazon because they are ridiculously expensive. Get them from Office Max, and Office Max has coupons. Anyway, this container contains the bears that we use, markers, different types of scissors. So one has like a zigzag cut and like a swirly cut and a straight cut, crayons, color pencils, and we have some magnetic letters and numbers. Let's move this globe out the way. The globe normally lives right here where the tree is. This is the clock that I showed you a few minutes ago, and see how it stands up. This container just contains dry erase markers and permanent markers, as well as pointers. And she really likes to use this because, I don't know, it's just sensational to her, I guess. Now, over here are all the things that I use for the calendar. Well, most of the stuff I use for the calendar. Eraser to erase up all up in here. Strips for our thing right here. Painter's tape. I know I mentioned this before, but I use it to hang certain paper on the wall. So we have numbers and the little gooey stuff, calendar pieces. I'm not going through all of this, but just know that's what's in this particular container. Over here by the stairs, there is another container that contains a lot of my manipulatives. So we have the Unifix cubes that I swear by. These things are so dope. And they play with them even outside of school. They just like to build stuff. So we have poker chips. There's some rocks in here, some horses, and some of those little colored chips that I told you that I use for one of the hands-on activities. Now, if we make our way over here, I'm not gonna go into everything that's popping off in here because, child, when I tell you that it is cold in this closet, it is cold. It's so cold in here, y'all. So this closet, let me step back so you can actually see what I'm talking about. This closet is not insulated, so it is chilly, so I'm not gonna spend a whole lot of time in here. These boxes, I have the kindergarten lesson plans and materials. It's so wild how much stuff you acquire. Here I have the decorations that I put on the wall. And yes, I have them inside of these envelopes and I have them labeled what it is and what season it goes to. This is some pre-K stuff, I'm sure. All of this stuff is pre-K stuff, so I'm not even going to get into all of that. Now over here, it is a mess, y'all. It's a mess right now. I haven't had a chance to put things up. At the end of the unit, I put all of the things that we're no longer going to use inside a plastic bag. Remember in one of the videos, I said that there was like these affirmations that were on the wall that they tore down. Well, I found them because somebody put them in here. But here they are, and I haven't put them back because we have that on the wall. Here is a game with featuring some magnet tiles. I talked about the magnet tiles and how they love them. We started out with this and then had to turn around and buy like 100 more because they love, love, love them. Some stem magnet stuff. Here is a box full of random stuff. What I did was I put this sheet of paper in here to tell me exactly what is in this box. Because at one point, I was buying stuff that I did not need. It's cold up in this mug. Woo. Now in this box is, girl, this box. In this box is all of the materials that we are no longer using for this school year. So we just finished up unit 7 with math. So that's gonna go in there. Here's the work that she did from December 7th through 11th. So I put everything back. You're probably like, but Shug, what is behind the curtain? It's a bunch of stuff back there. Whew. So that is it for this video. I hope that it was helpful. And I'm going to go because the video needs to be uploaded tomorrow. Oh my God, I'm so behind, y'all. And the kids are about to start coming up here and do what they got to do. All right, thank you so much for watching and supporting. And I will see you all tomorrow. Be blessed. Peace. Here they come. You hear the footsteps? Mm-hmm.